Hey YouTubers and makeup junkies alike, this is Michael Scott coming at you, and I thought I would do an eye. It's one that I did on my old channel, so if you watched my old channel, then you'll know this is the kind of orange, yellow, and purple eye. Now, this is a really fun eye to do, especially if you've got dark skin. Black women, it looks incredible on. They can take colors that a lot of people can't and just, they look amazing on them. So, a lot of benefits as far as makeup compatibility with eyeshadows. Like, you girls can do ombre lips. You know, you've been doing ombre lips for a long time. Nobody, before they were even calling them ombre lips. but you can pull off yellows really, really well. And so, it was actually a friend of mine that did an eye kind of like this. A friend of mine on Instagram. And I loved it. Loved it. Loved it. And so I did one a long time ago, but I thought we'd go ahead and revisit it here on the new channel. Now, I'm looking for a yellow, and I'm kind of struggling between Ben Nye, which is a really popular drag or female impersonator brand, or movie theater type makeup people use these. Ben Nye is really pigmented, amazing company. They're out of California, and they're a little bit pricey, but these are huge and they'll last you a long time. This one's a Lumiere, which is a really, really shimmery one. And then I've got the China Doll Goldfish, which I think I might use. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab the Lime Crime Eyeshadow Helper to start this one out. Sorry, I'm having a little bit of allergies and all that stuff. The wind has been going absolutely crazy today. I just wonder how planes are making it down over at the airport. There's a special maneuver that they have to do where they come in kind of sideways and then kick their rudder to the left to straighten out right before they hit the ground, that they generally have to do in these types of conditions. And I would be afraid to be aboard a plane when there's, like, you know, 80 mile an hour wind gusts. And, you know, this is also the time that microbursts can happen, so that's a scary thing as well. All right, so I've got that on, and I'm gonna grab some brushes. I moved a plant over here because it just was not getting enough sun where it was. So now it's taking up my Egyptian table and I'm getting crowded for space here again. Very quickly as well, I got a shipment in this week from Azature. They all have black diamonds in them, every single color. So if you don't know, they have several colors that are made with the diamonds in them. My favorites are the platinum and the red. It's Azature Red, and this is the platinum diamond. They're so incredibly beautiful. And then this last one I was thinking about for Jennifer. Jennifer, I think your box is going out this weekend. Me and Ellie were talking about it, and I think I can ship this weekend. But I was thinking this might be a color you might like for your wedding, so think about it, let me know. This is the white, the Azature White. Again, it does have a black diamond in there, just ground up. You only need to do like one coat of these as well. I did two coats of the white just because of the fact that it was a white. But it's absolutely beautiful. So I don't know if that's something maybe you want to rock on your wedding day, but if I get your bag out this weekend, I could probably throw this one in there and order myself another one. So, but yeah. So we're gonna start with that yellow. I'm just grabbing kind of a fat elf shadow brush and tapping it on. And I'm not gonna cover the lid completely. I'm gonna leave it just like so. Sorry, I'm moving the camera around. So just like so, and as you see, you know, it really takes just a little bit with the Lime Crime. That's why I love it. And, you know, orange is, even in my 88 palettes, I don't have any decent oranges. So I had to actually go out and buy an orange when I was doing my Pride Masquerade mask. And so I still use that orange because I just cannot find, or haven't picked up an orange or seen an orange that I just had to have. Unfortunately, I'm having trouble finding it. I know it's in this bottom drawer because the red was. There it is. Way in the back. So I'm going to grab, it's called Hot Orange. And we're going to go just on top of and around the yellow. And we're going to, the goal here is to eventually bleed this into a purple color. So, but you need, it looks best, I should say, with a little bit of orange and then a little bit of red and then purple. I really love this song. This is Macklemore. And this is before he was with Ryan Lewis. It's from, called the Unplanned Mixtape. And it's just under Michael, I'm saying Michael Jackson as he's singing about him. It's just under Macklemore. So, just get a little bit of orange around. And blend that in, and then grab a red, and you're gonna go right over the very top of that orange. We're kind of doing some color layering here. Not color blocking, but color layering. I'm just going to use the same brush because these two kind of really need to bleed into each other. And this is one where you want to transition a color, and I can tell you at this point I've probably already gone too high with it. Maybe not. So grab a clean brush and excuse me, I gotta take a quick drink. Oh my goodness, I'm just really stuffy. You know, it's that time of year, spring's coming in, and it's kicking up all the pollens. So, I might as well go with, I have a Ben Nye purple that's a Lumiere. Oh gosh, I hate to do a purple up there that's shimmered. This is the Palace Pedigree. Wait a minute, I know I've got a matte purple and Urban Decay, Lime Crime. So let's see if I can find a nice dark purple. There's one. That's a really, really matted one. Yeah, I think I'm going to go into the Aquitania Alchemy, the Alchemy palette, and go into Love Potion number 9. So that's a nice dark purple. And so I'm just going to grab this angled brush that I used to do a little bit of blending with. Start just at the outer corner. I think I'm gonna have to get a different brush. That one's not picking up enough. So I'm gonna move into the MAC 214. So time of day they start going hog wild because Mojo, it's not time yet. Daddy usually comes home at around this time, not this time, he usually comes home Mojo around 6:45, but their internal clocks kick in and they start barking for like an hour leading up to it, and anything and everything passing by kind of drives me crazy some days. And especially when it gets Wild Kingdom. Both the both the dogs barking, the birds squawking. Oh my goodness, it can get uber crazy in here. I just want to pull my hair out some days. Okay, so work it until you've got it kind of like so. So you've got the yellow, you've got the orange, you've got the red, you've got the purple, and you're just going to start working on blending those. The purple should kind of fade right into that red as it comes in. And you can go back and forth between these brushes. It's weird, there's something rattling against the window, but it almost sounds like rain or hail. So I keep expecting there to be when I look out the window, but there's not. Wrong brush. I did. I wondered. I was like, boy, that seems yellow. I may have just mixed it up a little too much to recover from. We'll see. Okay. You know, every time I do this eye, it comes out a little bit different. The shape of it. I think every time I do eyes, they come out a little bit different shape-wise. I don't know what my deal is with that, but I'm gonna grab just a flat brush for underneath the waterline, the 212. I don't know if you'll hear it on camera, but there's that rattling, and it's not raining or anything, it's just the wind is that heavy that it's blowing the window. Do my blue milk blue lipstick eye here again. I don't know if I ever recorded that one onto a video. I'll have to look, but it's one of my favorite eyes, and on my Instagram, which is Michael Scott MUA, I have a lot of likes on that. A lot of people like comment to their friends or will flag their friends or tag their friends in it to look at for inspiration or whatnot. Or maybe they're making fun of me, I don't know, I don't really care. But it's one of the one pictures that I get a lot of people liking and talking about on there. Okay, so we've got the bottom done. We've got the top done, and I've kind of got it, as I, you know, I've got the hooded crease. So, you know, this would be a much better eye for, you know, a younger lady that has, on the younger client that has just a big flat canvas, because you're going to see all of that beautiful work, and you get these nice gradients when you're blending those colors together. When you've got a hooded crease, it comes out a little bit different. You know, it's really only noticed when you're blinking or looking down, things like that. You do notice the orange within that area. I'll show you real quick. So, and I'm just, so you see the orange and red. And it's nighttime as well, so it's like 6 o'clock, so there's not super bright lights right now. Aside from my floodlight, which makes me melt. And again, it's bad hair day, so that's why I've got my hat on. So I really want to deepen up the outer corner. I'm tempted to take this Russian blue. But I think what I'm actually going to do is go into the Monster's Bride for the carbon. Carbon, and we'll pick some of that up. And you notice it right away. Now, oftentimes you can take a black and do your whole crease and all that area in black first, and then go over it with purples or other colors like that, and it actually can make them pop a lot more for you. So, and we'll kind of do that here in just a second, because I'm really not wanting this to be black. I'm wanting it to be a purple. I just want to see what other choices I've got for purples. I've got this one. it tends to turn black, and if I've already got black, that could definitely be a problem. So I'm gonna try and grab an e.l.f. loose pigment. Dismiss. That's my little reminder for auctions and things like that. Like, I'm such a junkie on those bid for assets and eBays and all those websites. Definitely didn't get enough ounce. So this is just one of the e.l.f. loose pigments. Yeah, these aren't the mineral ones, they're just the loose pigments, and these are actually really great shadows, especially when you've got a nice mixing medium. Theirs is the lock and seal, and I think I've touched on it before. So you can play around with those and excuse me, do a lot of fun things with them because they're so inexpensive. The way to do it though is to wait until e.l.f. is having one of their 50% off sales, which they'll do several times a year, and then just spend like 50 or 100 bucks and you can get gobs of, you know, the pigments. I got all the mattes last time I ordered. I got almost all of their cream liners, which unless you're gonna use them like every single day, I wouldn't do, because, you know, I've had a couple of them dry out on me. So just be wary of that, or be aware of that if you're ordering any liners from e.l.f. I love this song. I really like Anna Kendrick, but I hate the way they did her makeup in Pitch Perfect. I love that movie too, but her makeup throughout that entire movie just looks like a raccoon to me. She's just got these really heavy goth type eyes, and you know, I don't know if they're trying to make her look like a rebel or whatever, but to me it just looks horrendous. I really don't care for it at all. Not on her end. Just, yeah. So, we're looking for a highlight color. I might go with, we'll just use Mylar. I always use Mylar, and that's just a great color for my skin tone. You know, you'll find that color for your skin tone, and once you do, you'll end up going to it a lot, and there's really nothing wrong with that. I'm gonna get a good amount of this applied first before I start mixing, because that purple is going to go onto it, so. And then you want to do your really good mixing, blending. Hopefully this isn't gonna run out. I think I deleted everything off of this card. Me and Elliot are gonna do some shopping this weekend, so maybe I'll remember to get a larger memory card. You better work, cover girl, do a twirl. Alright, so let me grab a makeup wipe. Love, love. I'm used to my mix of this song. I remixed this song, and so whenever I hear it, I start singing as if it were my mix, and it's not. So my words are always off. Alright, so just a quick touch up or clean up of any fallout. We're gonna need to deepen up that dark purple. Okay, so and that's the elf, which I probably threw back in. So with these elf ones, if you haven't seen anything that I've done in the past, I generally leave the stickers on these and just pop the top off when I need to, because I find it can leak a lot of color. My black one definitely does. The purple one doesn't seem to have that problem, but the black most definitely does. Titty flash. Hey, toy. All right, so I'm gonna grab Truco by Sebastian, reflective one, and this one is in Spirit. These are great little highlight colors for like the inner corner. Shantae. Okay. All right, so. Whew. It's almost like I'm having hot flashes and going through menopause. Jesus Louise. Between the heat, I think our thermostat is close to the front room where DOG is. And he, of course, has a space heater because he needs to stay really, really warm. So I think it always reads hotter than normal because of that, and therefore we have to turn the heat up higher, and some rooms just get really, really hot while others would be really cold, which this room is a perfect example. Okay, so now again, like I said, see, I might blend a little. And so there's, like I said, a lot of color going on in this eye. It looks fabulous on darker skin tones, but you can pull it off too, just if you're light, fair skin toned. I just wouldn't do a lot more busyness on the face when it comes to that. I've said it a million times, if you're doing this extravagant or really dramatic eye, you want to keep everything else kind of simple and moderate. But I mean, heck, I don't know if you wanted to, if you're going clubbing or whatever, you could do like a rhinestone ombre lip, or, you know, rhinestone lips. You can do spiked lips, you can do spikes in your hair, you can do all that kinds of stuff if you're going clubbing. I think that's kind of the exception to the rule. You know, you can really get crazy when you're going out clubbing, with what you're wearing makeup wise and clothing wise, all that good stuff. I mean, you can rock it all out. So that's it. I'm not sure how this one compares to my other ones. I'm gonna have to take pictures and look, and we'll see if this video makes the cut for publishing. I've got so many that don't. It's rather sad, actually. Just because, you know, I don't like to do a lot of editing and spend a lot of time here fiddle-faddling with that stuff. And there's just other things I could be doing. But, you know, I'm not trying to be like Michelle Phan, like she's taken her YouTube channel and kind of made a career, a lifestyle out of it, and, you know, that's not really what I'm wanting to do. I love working with and doing makeup, and I like to be able to share it with people, and, you know, also just, you know, for other guys that are out there, gays, transgender, anybody, you know, that wants to play around with makeup, you know, and might have hesitation or reservations or be scared to whatever, you know, I just think that, you know, it's a good thing to have a presence. You know, back in... I really wanted to make sure that I'd got this thing yesterday. Back, you know, 60s and before, all makeup artists on lots of movie studios were generally men. I mean, there were some women, but they generally were men, so... It's okay to be a guy and play around with makeup and do makeup. And in today's, you know, nowadays, I think more than ever, it's acceptable for a guy. I'm gonna grab Stila, just because I love this pen, black. But yeah, I mean, it's 2014, for Christ's sakes. If you guys wanna wear a little bit of makeup, mascara, liner, then do it. And then, I mean, I'll wear base and foundation, things like that. Ooh. I ended up going really thick right there. Bad. So we'll just have this one be a thick liner. And I like to bring the liner up at the end, just on my eye shape. It's not really a cat eye. It's just a little tiny flit up. And I guess some people would call it a cat eye, but I don't really think it is. It's just a little flit at the end that comes up. And it's just to kind of pick up the eye, because I have hooded eyes and... just kind of helps pick them up a little bit. So, now another thing that can be done, if it's like not perfect, your liner, and you're getting like these little, you can see them, the little, like you just want a perfect line across there, you can keep doing that with, like you can use a cream eyeliner, you can use your stick and keep going back and forth over it, or you can grab a powder, and I'll grab Carbon from MAC, and the 266. When it comes to this, you really, really want a good brush. So the 266 is, you know, my friend Michelle says it's the best investment she ever made. Just take that and go over and do your liner. So I think this is just about to cut out. So I want to say, have fun with your makeup. As always, this is Michael Scott, and enjoy yourself, you know, have that fun. So you just take that black over it. Can also help mattify this. You can fix, you know, mistakes. It helps set it as well. And if you're not talking, fully focused, you can get a perfect line. But honestly, I've got to say, I'm rarely like 100% focused when I'm doing these videos. I probably should be, but with the dogs and everything else, it can be a challenge. So, man, we're about 30 minutes in, so that deepened it up, helped flatten it out. You can take a little bit of black on the bottom if you want to deepen that up. You want to make sure that connects. As you can see, that little flap of skin looked like it wasn't fully covered. And this 266 is just a great brush for getting into areas like that, inner corner. You know, if you're wanting to do the the Egyptian eye, like the Eye of Horus or the Eye of Ra or whatever. This can be a great handy tool for doing that as well. The pens can work as well. It just depends on how well you are and how steady-handed you are. You know, I did the Lady Gaga Judas Eye on my old channel. That was a challenge. All right, guys, that's it for this one. This is Michael Scott saying have fun. Have fun with your makeup. Don't forget your mascara. All right, bye, guys.